Good morning, children. Today, I, Purnima, welcome you all to my class of English. And children, today I am going to revise the drama Mother's Day. So we all know that this drama is having five characters here. One is Mrs. Anne Pearson. Doris, her daughter, Doris Pearson. Cyril Pearson is her son. George Pearson is her husband. And Mrs. Fritz Zerold. She is a friend of Mrs. Pearson, and a student. She is the one who give a guidance and motivation to Mrs. Fritz, Mrs. Pearson, that how to get a respect in her own house. And children, we all know that the play begins with two friends having a conversation at Mrs. Pearson's house. Now, who were these two friends? These two friends were Anne Pearson and Mrs. Fitzgerald. Now, Mrs. Fitzgerald is telling Mrs. Pearson fortune and advises her on it. Mrs. Pearson goes about telling how her family members don't value her and don't appreciate her that whatever she does for them. So she tells, she shares whatever she is having, all the secrets she tells to her. And she tells that she is available for them for all the 24 hours. And they just come, they throw orders, and they leave without even saying thank you. Mrs. Fitzgerald tells her to take her stand as the woman of the house. But Mrs. Pearson, she is so sweet of by her nature, and she is such an innocent lady that she tell that if I will be doing that, the her whole family will be in discomfort. Now she is telling that she is continue to face their tantrums because she doesn't know where to begin with. The whole family was behaving with her very badly, but she don't know where to begin with. And she was the one, she was children facing all the tantrums because she doesn't know where to begin when it comes to making them disciplined. Mrs. Fitzgerald proposes a plan to switch their body so that Mrs. Fitzgerald takes her place without her family knowing. Mrs. Pearson is hesitant at first, but then Mrs. Fitzgerald convinces her for it. Mrs. Fitzgerald performs her magic that she had learned from the East, and their personalities are changed. Now, Mrs. Fitzgerald performs her magic that she had learned from the East, and their personality are changed. So, children, she knows the art. Mrs. Fitzgerald actually knows the art that how to change their personality, and she advises her to change the personality. At first, Mrs. Pearson doesn't agree. But then finally she made her, Mrs. Fitzgerald, her friend, convinces her to her, and she is agreeing for that. Well, Mrs. Fitzgerald, she performed the magic which she had learned from the East. Okay, and now their personalities are changed. Mrs. Fitzgerald, she now becomes Mrs. Pearson, and Mrs. Pearson becomes Mrs. Fitzgerald. Now Mrs. Fitzgerald is actually Mrs. Pearson body, and vice versa. Now new Mrs. Pearson tell Fitzgerald to go to her house for the time being. At this moment in the play, Doris Pearson, Mrs. Pearson's daughter, she appears. And she enters the scene by asking the tea and ordering Mrs. Pearson to iron her yellow silk. She gets shocked at the sight of her mother, because she never saw her mother smoking, and that was the day she was shocked that her mother was smoking. Now, so Mrs. Pearson enters the scene asking for tea, and she, Doris Pearson, she also tells that she has to go somewhere. So she warned that her mother should iron that yellow silk. She gets shocked at the sight of her mother smoking, and from there the arguments begin, where Mrs. Pearson inserts Charlie Spencer, who was the boyfriend of Doris Pearson, and to with whom she was going to go outside. Doris leaves crying, and Cyril, her brothers, enter asking for tea. Now children, she refuses that she will not iron, and she also tells that she will not prepare tea. She cry as well as she insult Mrs. Pearson. She tells rudely to Doris that if she would have been in her place, she would never have been a boyfriend like Charlie Spence. When Doris heard this, she started crying and she went outside. And then only her brother Cyril enters for tea and something to eat. He too is amazed when he saw her mom, that she is, today she is not providing, she is not giving her any tea to drink and nothing to eat. Now he asks Mrs. Pearson, what is wrong with you, mom? Mrs. Pearson tells him that she had never felt better. Cyril gets annoyed and Doris joins him, where they are told that Mrs. Pearson might even take the weekend off. Next, George Pearson enters the scene. George Pearson is a husband. Shocked to see his wife day drinking. He had never seen his wife day drinking. So he was very much shocked that his wife is drinking. He announces that he has some special match at the club and that he won't be requiring any tea this afternoon. On being told there is no tea, he gets annoyed again. Mrs. Pearson mocks him for getting annoyed, and she further taunts him that this would not have happened had he stayed at home once in a while, because there everybody insulted him. Indirectly, everybody has given him, they call him by some name. After a while, Mrs. Pearson Fitzgerald enter. She interferes in their family matters. George gets annoyed when Mrs. Fitzgerald calls him by his name, but just like it had been happening all day, Mrs. Pearson barges in to bring George on track. Now children, Doris enters the scene, and she too is not very pleasant to Mrs. Fitzgerald. Mrs. Pearson brings her on track too. At this point, Mrs. Fitzgerald, actually she is Mrs. Pearson, loses her cool and asks the family members to excuse the two friends for a moment. She promises them she know how to make the situation better. Mrs. Fitzgerald asks Mrs. Pearson to switch their bodies, and while Mrs. Fitzgerald resists at first, but later she agrees to do it. They repeat the process they did in the first place. The real Mrs. Fitzgerald now explained Mrs. Pearson how important it is for her to be a bit dominating once in a while to establish her control over her family. Now children, the family enters, and Mrs. Pearson suggests that today she would play rummy and the kids will make supper. Everyone instantly agrees and they are a bit relieved too. Mrs. Fitzgerald exits and the play ends. So children, finally what happened? She brings everybody on track. Who? It was actually Miss Fitzgerald who actually changes into Mrs. Pearson. So children, this is the whole background of this drama. Okay. And we can guess what happens, children, at the last. Mrs. Pearson, she gets a lot of respect. She becomes the mistress of her house, okay? And everybody obeys her. So now, children, I'm starting with the explanation of the play. We have already done the first part. And we are here from Mrs. Fitzgerald hint. It's more than hint your family need from here. Mrs. Pearson, I suppose it is, but I do hate any unpleasantness. and it's so hard to know where to start. Now, children, Mrs. Fitzgerald is advising her. She is telling her that why don't she bring her family to the track? And Mrs. Fitzgerald, Mrs. Pearson, who is telling, I don't know from where to begin. Good gracious, look at the time, nothing ready, and they will be home any minute and probably all in a hurry to go out again. Now, children, she is worried that till now she has not made anything for them. And very soon they will be coming, they will be giving their orders, and they will all go outside. And nothing ready, and they will be all home any minute and probably all in a hurry to go out again. As she is about to rise, Mrs. Fitzgerald reaches out across the table and pulls her down. Now, children, when Mrs. Fitzgerald hears all these things, she pulls her down and she tells, let them wait or look after themselves for once. She advises her friend, they are so grown up. Let them wait for some minutes. Why do you will run and go for them? This is where your food goes down, and here you have to keep your food down. Start now. She lights a cigarette from the one she has just finished. Mrs. Pearson, embarrassed. Mrs. Pearson was very much embarrassed. Mrs. Fitzgerald, I know you mean well. In fact, I agree with you, but I just can't, and it's no use trying to make me. If I promise you, I would really have it out with them. I know I would not be able to keep my promise. So, children, Mrs. Pearson, she became embarrassed. She tells Mrs. Fitzgerald, I know you mean well. That means you are thinking so well of me, so fine of me. In fact, I agree with you. In fact, she tells, she agrees with her. But I just can't, and it's no use you trying to make me. If I promise you, I would really have it out with them. I know I would not be able to keep my promise. Mrs. Fitzgerald, then let me do it. Mrs. Pearson, oh no, thank you very much, Mrs. Fitzgerald, but that would not do at all. It could not possibly be somebody else. They would resent it at once and would not listen. Now, she told they will not listen to anybody else. They would resent it at once and could not listen. And really, I could not blame them. I knew I ought to do it, but you see how it is. She looks apologetically across the table, smiling rather miserably. Now, children, some word meaning. Flustered means agitated or confused. Resent means feel bitterness or indignation at a circumstances. Now, the dialogues, the conversation is still continuing. Mrs. Fitzgerald, coolly, you haven't got the idea. She tells Mrs. Pearson that she has no idea how successful the idea can be. Mrs. Pearson, I'm sorry, I thought you asked me to let you do it. Mrs. Fitzgerald, I did, but not as me as you. Mrs. Pearson told, but I don't understand, you could not be me. Mrs. Fitzgerald, we change places or really bodies. You look like me, I look like you. So Mrs. Fitzgerald removed her confusion. She told him, I can be you, I can take your place and you can take my place. Mrs. Pearson, but that is impossible. Mrs. Fitzgerald, how do you know? Have you ever tried it? So she is telling, have you ever tried? That is not impossible. If you will try it, you will know it. Mrs. Pearson, no, of course not. Mrs. Fitzgerald, I have not for some time, but it still ought to work. Mrs. Fitzgerald telling, though I have not tried for some time, but still I would like to work. And I've learned it out east, of course, where they are up to all these tricks. And she tells that her husband was there in the east and she has learned her tricks. Grime your hands here. So Mrs. Pearson, dubiously, well, I don't know, it's right. Mrs. Fitzgerald telling, yes, it is right. And then they catch hold of hand of each other. They look into each other eyes, and children, they both look, she murmurs something, and Mrs. Fitzgerald is now a bit shy, and Mrs. Pearson has become unafraid. Mrs. Pearson, see what I mean, dear. She notices a cigarette here, you don't want it. She snatches it and puts it in her own mouth, puffing constantly. Now, children, the personality of both the ladies had changed. Mrs. Friggs Pearson has become Mrs. Friggs at all, and Mrs. Friggs at all has become Mrs. Pearson. Mrs. Pearson, who actually is Mrs. Friggs at all, she is smoking cigarette. Mrs. Fixer, now with Mrs. Pearson personality, looks down at herself and sees that her body has changed and gives a scream of fright. Mrs. Fixer, oh, it's happened. Now Mrs. Fixer told, see, we have tried and it has happened. We both have changed. Mrs. Pearson, of course it's happened. Very neat. Didn't know it had it in me. Now children, what is the meaning of compliance? Complacently, complacently means showing smug or uncritical satisfaction with oneself or one's achievements. Mrs. Fitzgerald. But whatever shall I do, Mrs. Fitzgerald? George and the children can't see me like this. Mrs. Pearson. They aren't going to. That's the point. They will have me to deal with. Only they won't. So she is telling, see, you are smoking as Mrs. Pearson. They can't take it. So she is telling, they will take it. They will know how to deal with me. And then they will know what is a, how to deal with the ladies. Now children, the meaning of grimly is bitter or hard manner. So children, now Mrs. Fitzgerald, she is both a change. And she is very nicely, she is teaching a lesson to the husband and the daughter and son of Mrs. Pearson. Now some word meaning which you have to notice, one is grimly. Grimly means bitter. What is the meaning of grimly? Grimly means bitter. Of grimly student is bitter. Now Mrs. Fitzgerald, she is she tells that what if we can't change back, it would be terrible. So Mrs. Pearson, who is now actually Mrs. Fitzgerald, she is telling, if you had to leave my life, it would not be so bad. You have more fun as me than you could had as you. So Mrs. Fitzgerald is advising that enjoy the life which I was leading, okay, and let me bring all the person on track in your house, and then you can change. I will be changing you. Mrs. Fitzgerald, yes, but I don't want to be anybody else. Now children, Mrs. Fitzgerald, who is really a Mrs. Pearson, she tells me, I don't want to be anybody else, Mrs. Pearson. Now, stop worrying. It's easier changing back. I can do it anytime we want. Now, children, Mrs. Fitzgerald, she tells, it is easier to change back. Anytime, if you want, I can do it. Mrs. Pearson, not like I've got to deal with your family first. That's the idea. It's not it. Didn't know how to begin with them, you said. Well, I will show you. Now children, she at the same time, she told Mrs. Pearson that till now you were telling how to deal with them. So now I am going to show you how to deal with your family. Mrs. Fitzgerald, but what am I going to do? Mrs. Pearson, go into my house for a bit. There is nobody there. Then pop back and see how we are doing. And see children, she is telling, if you want to come, you can see how I am bringing them to the track. You ought to enjoy it. Better get off now before one of them comes. Mrs. Fitzgerald, yes, I suppose that's the best. You are sure I will be all right. Mrs. Pearson, it will be wonderful. Now off you go, dear. Mrs. Fitzgerald crosses and hurries out through the right door. Left to herself, Mrs. Pearson smokes away, lighting and the cigarettes, and begin laying out the cards for patience on the table. After a few moments, Doris Pearson comes bursting in left. She is a pretty girl in her early 20s who would be pleasant enough if she had not been spoiled. So children, Doris Pearson is Mrs. Pearson's daughter. She is 20 years of age and she is a spoiled brat. And she comes, she enters the house and let's see how she is dealing with her mother. Doris. Mom, you will have to iron my uniforms. Now, children, as soon as she enter, she started giving order. She told you have to iron my yellow silk. I must wear it tonight. And what are you doing? She moves down left center. Astounded means shocks or greatly surprised. So she instructs her mom to press her dress. Now Mrs. Pearson, she has used her ordinary voice, but her manner is not fluttering and she is cool and incisive. She told, what do you think I'm doing? Whitewashing the ceiling. Now she is telling, what are you doing? Can't you see what I'm doing? Whitewashing the ceiling. Fluttering means trembling. Incisive means intelligently, analytical and clear thinking. So children, Doris, she is still astounded. She is very much surprised at how till now her mother has never spoken like that and how she is speaking today. And she is astounded that she is telling, you are smoking, Mrs. Pearson. That's right, dear. No law against it. Is there? Now she is telling, there is no law. Nobody can stop me from smoking because there is no law for that. Doris, but I thought you did not smoke. Now Doris is saying, but I thought you never smoke. Mrs. Pearson, then your thought is wrong. Mrs. Pearson straight away she told, then your thought is completely wrong. She bluntly replies to Doris. Doris, are we having tea in the kitchen? Mrs. Pearson, have it where you like, dear. Now she did not prepare the tea. At the same time, she tells him, wherever you feel like having the tea, you have it. Doris, do you mean it is not ready? Now Doris is telling, do you mean it is not ready? Mrs. Pearson, it is not. She told, yes, it is not ready. I've had all I want. Might go out later and get a square meal at the Clarendon. She is telling, not only tea, I have not prepared the meal also, and maybe today's meal I will go outside and have it at Clarendon. Naturally, Doris and say, it's not me that's being silly, and I must say it's a bit much when I've been working hard all day and can't even bother to get my tea ready. Now Doris is telling, I've been working hard all day and you can't even bother to get my tea ready. Did you hear what I said about my yellow silk? And she also told that, can you hear what I was talking to you about my yellow silk? Mrs. Pearson, no, don't you like it? No, I never did. Now say Mrs. Pearson told that she refused to have heard anything about her dress. Doris, indignantly, of course I like it and I'm going to wear it tonight, so I want it ironed. Mrs. Pearson, want it ironed? What do you think it's going to do, iron itself? Now she's telling you, if you want to get ironed, then do it by yourself. The iron will not come and it won't, your dress will not be ironed by itself. No, you are not going to iron it for me. You always do. Now Doris is surprised. She told, you always iron for me, so why don't you do it? Mrs. Pearson, well, this time I don't. She told, this time I'm not going to do any more iron. And don't talk rubbish to me about working hard. I have good idea how much you do. Doris Pearson, I put in twice the hours you do and get no wages for thanks for it. Now she told, even I work very hard and for that I never get any wages and any thanks. Why are you going to wear your yellow silk? Where are you going? Now she asked, where are you going? Why are you putting your yellow silk? Doris sulky, out with Charlie Spencer. Doris. So Mrs. Pearson tell, why? Doris say, why, what's the matter with you? Why should not I go out with Charles? So she told me, I don't want that you should go out with that boy. So she told me, why? If he asks me and I want to, any objection, go on, you might as well tell me. Mrs. Pearson, can't you find anybody better? Now Mrs. Pearson insult her boyfriend also. She tell, can't you find anything better? I would not be seen dead with charred spence, buck teeth and half witted. Not so what she is telling. He is having a buck teeth and he is half witted. Doris, he is not. Now Doris says in Louis can't bear what Mrs. Pearson is telling about her boyfriend. She said he is not. And she tried to defend Charlie Spencer. Mrs. Pearson, when I was of your age, I would have found somebody better than Charlie Spencer, given myself up as a bad job. Doris, oh, shut up. Doris run out left. Mrs. Pearson chuckles and begins putting the cards together. After a moment, Cyril Pearson enters left. He is a masculine, gentle person. Cyril, hello, ma'am. Is tea ready? Mrs. Pearson said no. Cyril, moving to the table, annoyed, why not? Mrs. Pearson, I could not bother. Cyril, feeling off color or something. Mrs. Pearson, never felt better in my life. Now, Mrs. Pearson, she told him, I never felt better in my life. Cyril, what's the idea then? Mrs. Pearson, she told, just a change. I did not prepare the tea because I really want to have some change. Well, snap out of it, ma, and get cracking. Having too much time. I is telling ki, ma, just prepare the tea quickly. I don't have time. Okay. Mrs. Pearson, but I've got plenty of time. Cyril, yes, but I haven't got a busy night tonight. And did you put my things out? Mrs. Pearson, can't remember, but I doubt it. Now she tells me, I did not put your things out. I did not even remember what things were. I have to put it. Cyril, moving to the table, protesting. Now look, when I asked you this morning, you promised. You said you would have to look through them first in case that there was any mending. So she reminded her mother at what she said in the morning. Mrs. Pearson, well, now I have been decided I don't like mending. Now Mrs. Pearson told, but I don't like mending now. Cyril, that's nice way to talk. What would happen if we all talk like this? Now Cyril is telling, what would happen if we all talk like that? Mrs. Pearson, you all do talk like that. If there is something at home you don't want to do it, you don't do it. If there is something at your work, you get the union to bar it. Now all that's happened is that I've joined the movement. Cyril, I don't get this, mom. What's going on? Mrs. Pearson, she is in the process of dressing and is now wearing a wrap. Now children, even Cyril is surprised at why the mother is behaving like that. Mrs. Pearson, she is telling, she is rising and preparing to move to the kitchen. Have any stout left? I can't remember. So children, what is a stout? It's a kind of strong dark beer brewed with roasted malt or barley. Cyril, bottle or two, I think, but you don't want stout now. Now he is telling, but I know you don't want stout now. Mrs. Pearson, I do. She told, yes, I do want. Cyril, what for? Mrs. Pearson, turning to the door, to drink. You clot. Clot is a foolish or clumsy person. Mrs. Pearson, exit right. Instantly, Cyril and Doris are in a huddle. Close together at left center, rapidly whispering, Doris, has she been like that with you too? Now children, Cyril, he is not, never seen her mother drinking and her behavior was something very unusual. So he asked his sister, Cyril asked if she was behaving with you also like that. Yes, no tea ready, could not care less. Now she is telling she did not want to care. And when I came, the territory was also not ready. Doris, well, I'm glad it's both of us. I thought I have done something wrong. Now children, Doris telling it's good. I thought that even I only, it was me who had done wrong. But I think we both are suffering the same thing. Cyril, so did I, but it is of course. Doris, she was smoking and playing cards when I came in. I could not believe my eyes. Now Doris is telling, when I came in, my mother was playing cards and she was smoking, which I could not believe. I asked her if she was feeling off color and she said she was not. Doris, where she is suddenly all different. Now Doris is telling her brother that her mother is suddenly, which she is became so behaving in a very different way. Ah, that's what made me cry. It wasn't what she said, but the way she said it and the way she looked. She telling him, I did not cry because what she said. I cried because the way she said it and the way she looked. So she is amazed by the difference in her. She tells Siren that it's not her words that hurt her, but the look in her eyes that made her cry. Siren, haven't noticed that she looks just the same to me. Doris, she doesn't to me. Do you think she could have hit her head or something, you know, and got what is it, you know? Siren, staggered. Do you mean she is balmy? Balmy means mad or crazy. Now, both brother and sister, they think whether she has become crazy or mad or not. She might have become crazy because they have never seen her mother children behaving like that. So with this, I end my video here. Thank you and have a nice day ahead.